So what is your drag name?
My drag name is Evie Oddly. I was born right here in Denver, Colorado. I started doing drag because my mom and I always loved Halloween, and one year we decided to dress up as a dead hooker, and she was my pimp. And I loved the attention I got that day at school. Like, it was the best feeling. And even though it took me like a few years later to actually like get into doing drag again, when I grew up and was living on my own and could spend my money how I liked, I don't know, I just had to go back to it. It was nice. It's like so empowering being in drag, so. Started on Halloween and now I'm a real queen. I always thought that I was just like another kid, and apparently I wasn't. Even though I like know my dad and he is in town, and I got to see my dad on weekends. As growing up, I was mostly with my mom. It was mostly her who was raising me. I have a very strong relationship with my mom. I really wanted to be like taken seriously on the scene, but I knew it was hard to do if you weren't 21. So I tried out for Denver's Ultimate Queen, and despite like doing backflips and kicks and tricks and having Nina Flowers, who is our only RuPaul's Drag Race girl here in Denver, like telling all of the judges they should pick me, I got glossed over. And that made me so angry that like I spent that entire year just like doing drag almost every day, painting my face, like practicing like different things in heels, because I knew that when I came back the next year I wanted to win it, and so I did. Despite the fact that the competition pushed me a lot to try a lot of things that I didn't know about drag, getting out into the real world and getting to travel and getting to perform in different spaces and learn how different audiences react to what I have to do or say on stage has been amazing. I think Evie's fully developed as in no longer is drag some gimmick for me. It's not like I put on makeup to become some other person, even though there is that transformation. I do it to become myself. But in that, I feel like I still have plenty that I need to explore about what it means to be me and what it means to be even just human. Because when I'm on stage, I'm not necessarily always telling my stories. I'm just telling stories. And there's still more things I can do and need to learn how to do and try, but I just love to be traveling and spreading my name, spreading my legs. I ain't done shit all my life. Hey, I'm about to spend 4, about 5. Hey, I'm about to spend all this money. For the longest time, drag was mostly cisgender males performing acts of femininity that were scrutinized or beaten or killed for displaying in everyday life. So it's kind of like any other art movement if there wasn't that oppressive force. And I think both male and female, like traditional gender roles, are that oppressive force, then drag wouldn't have come forth and it wouldn't be as important right now to our culture as it is. There's so many things that drag can do or be, but it's not just gay men anymore, although they get the most spotlight. I know a handful of like bisexual and straight, like male, I know genderqueer and like agendered and two-spirit drag queens. I know plenty of like hyper queens or bio queens or like whatever they want to call themselves, like cis female drag queens. I know, like, drag monsters. The message that I would have for the kids out there is it's better to learn your own truth than listen to somebody else's.
I want to wear flats because I have bad back pain right now and I'm going to be doing lots of breakdancing. And so I like designed an entire look around a bitch who's going to be breakdancing and has a bad back. On acid.